Hello everyone, my name is Praveen and today I am going to talk about inheritance in C# programming. So inheritance is basically something which you can inherit from another class, right? So it is like a parent-child relationship where a child can inherit some of the qualities of a parent. Similarly, in C#, using the objects, you can create the same kind of relationship where you have a base class and then a derived class, and using this base and derived class you can declare some properties or methods in the base class and then inherit those properties and methods in the child class. So I'll also talk about the constructors, how you use these constructors in base class and derived class in this kind of relationships. This is a very popular interview question actually, so we'll go through it in a moment. So if you want, so what I am doing here is I'm using Visual Studio 2022. So a lot of people are asking me in comments that they don't get the same kind of interface because you have to use this. So you can see here Microsoft Visual Studio Community 2022 edition 64-bit. Okay, so this is what I am using. You can download this, you can find the links in the description below. So download this, install it, and create a console application using DotNet 6.0. So you can see, if I go to this property, double click this C# project here, and you can see it is DotNet 6.0. Okay, so this is the latest DotNet core framework. So I'll suggest you to start using this because this is supported by Microsoft, and Microsoft encourages its users, developers to use DotNet 6.0. Okay. So it is a very solid framework, so please start using it and learn about it. So once you have created this console application, you can actually you can see that this is the program.cs class, and this is how the structure is. Okay, so you will, the default is main, so you will not find the explicit main method here. So now let's create another class. If you want to run through this example, we have to create some class. So right click, click on class, and let's name it as person. Okay, so we have a person class. Let's define a constructor, person, public person, a constructor, and let's have a method called as walk. Distance. So you pass the distance, and then what it will do is it will actually tell you how much distance it has walked. Okay. So walked, if you pass one, so it'll show walked 1 kilometers or 2 kilometers, like this, it'll show you, okay? So that's the basic thing. Now, this is, let's call this as our base class, okay? So this is our base class called as person. Now, so consider this kind of a parent. Now it can have child, it can have multiple child. Well, let's create one child class here. Class, let's call this as employee. Okay, so here sorry, it is internal class, and then employee will be derive from person class. Okay. So one thing to note here is that you must provide an appropriate constructor in the base class. If you have provided a constructor in the derived class and no constructor in the base class, then that is considered as an error. Okay, so you should basically have a constructor in the base class, definitely. Okay, we can also have a constructor here, public employee, and we now have a constructor in our derived class. Okay. What we can do is, so since you have seen, you can check see here that there is no method, okay, but we can still use this method. So I will show you how we can use this method. So let's go to program. So here you can see the namespace is this constructor inheritance, so we have to use this namespace using constructor inheritance. Now let's declare a employee object, saying new employee. Okay. Now, so once you have a employee object, let's try to call employee.walk. You can see that I'm able to access that method which is in the base class. So this method is not there in the derived class, but this is there in the base class. So I pass a integer and then let me say read line, and now you have this employee. So if we run this, so it should print walked 2 kilometers, right? So let's try to run this. So you can see here, so walked 2 kilometers. Okay, so this is our interface. Okay, now a popular interview question here is that, so in this kind of scenario where you are inheriting from a base class, which constructor will be called first? Okay, so let me try to show it to you using a practical example. So what I can do is, let me write something here, console dot write line base class constructor. Okay. And then add a line here saying that it is the derived class. Okay, if I run this now, so it should print these messages. Okay, so let's see which one is coming first. Yeah, so now you can see the base class constructor is getting called first, then the derived class, and then this walk method. So which means in this kind of scenario, when you are deriving from the parent class, so always the parent class constructor will be called first, and then only the child class constructor. Okay, which means base and derived. First base, then derived. What if you want nobody to inherit from this derived class? In that case, there is a keyword called as sealed, which you can use. So if you use sealed here, then nobody will be able to inherit from your class. Okay, now you can see that I am getting an error. Now employee cannot derive from sealed type person. So sealed means it is completely blocked, right? You cannot inherit from this person class or this base class, right? So that is the use of sealed. So this is also another interview question. So what is the use of sealed, or how do you stop someone from inheriting from a class? So in that case, you should say that, okay, use the sealed keyword, where we don't want anybody to use the properties and methods in our class. We want it to be specific to this particular class. So that is the sealed class. Okay, now another variation which we can do is a constructor. There can be multiple type of constructors, right? So you can have parameterless constructors, you can have constructors with parameters. Okay, for example, you can have a constructor like this which accepts some parameters. Let's say string name. Okay, base class constructor, and let's print this. Right, so name. So you can have a constructor like this. So what if I want to call this constructor before actually calling another constructor. Let's now run it again and see which constructor is getting called called first. Okay, so let's run it. So now you can see that the parameter constructor is not getting called. So which means the default is always the parameterless constructor, which is getting called as I showed you in the previous run. So but the constructor with the parameter is not getting called. Okay, so now I have added a constructor with parameters, but we don't have any constructor with parameters here. So let's add one more constructor like this, which is basically a same like this, but it is in the derived class. Okay, so when this is called, it will say that derived class constructor and the name, whatever we are passing. So if we want to call this constructor explicitly, then we have to go back here, and then instead of calling the parameter constructor, we can say like this. So what will happen is it will invoke this parameter constructor with the parameter, not the constructor without the parameter. Okay, so that is what it will do when we run this application. And then what will happen is, before that, obviously this will be called, this will definitely be called, because this is the default. Yeah, the default constructor will always be called in the parent class, so that's very important. So whenever, doesn't matter how many constructors you have here and which constructor you are calling when you are initializing an object, but thing is that the base class default constructor will always be called, right? So let's run it again and see how this execution is happening. So you can see the base class constructor, default constructor is getting called, and then the derived class constructor, and then the method, right? So that is what is how the execution is happening. So what if I want to call this particular constructor whenever this constructor is getting called? So in that case, you can use the use of the base keyword. Okay, base, and then let's pass a parameter, and we can say, okay, pass name to our base, which is this constructor. So whatever name I am passing here, so I can pass the same name to my base class as well. All right, so let's run it and then see. So this time the base class parameter constructor will also be called, right? So you can see here, so base class constructor John, derived class constructor John, and worked. Now the point here is that you can see that this constructor is not getting called anymore, because explicitly we are saying that, okay, call this parameter constructor in the base class. So which means don't call another constructor here. Okay, so that's how it works, and that is how the behavior is. Hope I have clarified some of your doubts. These are very popular questions, and many interviews, if they want to understand how much knowledge you have on the basics of inheritance and constructors, they will definitely ask you this kind of questions. So hope this will help you in your career and in your future.